Making visuals, designs for presentations, blogs, and even videos just got a whole lot easy with this game changer of a tool. You want to add a flowchart to your deck? Sure. How about putting some visuals together for your teacher slides? No problem. Gotta explain a complex thought to your dumbass boss? Easy peasy. Content creators, writers, teachers, or analysts whose job is to make fancy ass decks 24/7, like half my consultant friends in the Big Four doing God knows what, it's time to start using this new ingenious tool called Napkin AI. Yes. Make visuals for your texts in seconds. Designing got a whole lot easier. And honestly, this is just the simple stuff. Because in this video, I'm also going to show you how you can use Napkin AI in collab with another tool to make maximum use of AI for your workflows. So hello and welcome to this episode and series called Hustle Hatch. It's time to check out Napkin AI in... Alright, so let's see what I've been on and on about and why I believe this tool is going to make creating graphic visuals halwa. Oh, by the way, it's still in its beta stage, which means forgive them for some of the errors while at the same time take full advantage of the fact that it is free. I don't know how long that's going to last, but I do know that this has a wide range of applications whether you work in education, marketing or whatever other field. So super quick onboarding, right, with some questions that you need to answer for yourself. And as you can see, either you can upload a source or generate text using AI. So let's start with that so that you can get a little bit of a feeler of what exactly you can do with this tool, right? Quick prompt, something at the top of my head, right? Opening email content, introducing the receiver to the tool. Basically, this is going to be, the first mail that comes through if somebody subscribes to your tool, right? Let's say it's a video editing tool, for example. To streamlining content or streamlining spelling and video output workflows. Oops, capability spelling. Apologies, I do know how to spell that word. But anyway, point being, straight away, notes already created, key features called out that would probably be there in a welcome mail. Maybe it's up to me to kind of pick what I would want to use, for example. What's the crazy part though that I've been harping on about? Not that as much as this. Just highlight that particular section, click on this blue lightning here, and spark is what happens on your notes, right? Crazy infographics, various kind of templates for you to choose from that you think best communicates your content. This, for example, works for something that I'm going for, right? And then picking the style itself, you know, if there's a particular visual theme, if it's flatter or if it's a little raw in some sense, basically, right? Those kind of options as well for you to tinker with. And then, of course, a fully editable image that comes out, you know, if you want to change the font, for example, and of course, fix yet another spelling mistake there, but basically in line with what exactly is the theme that works for your document, right? That kind of control given to you. Change the colors, tweak the words, position it the right way. Lot of flexibility in that sense. And wow, imagine if you are able to create visuals like that in seconds that would normally have dependency on a designer, for example, right? Just having another look, intuitive interface. Just understanding that concept itself, right? Spark AI will provide different layouts and something more in line with what I... There we go. Yeah, that looks just fine, right? You know, in terms of intuitive interface, the three pointers called out. And this for sure is how I'll be creating my visuals, especially for my decks and blogs and stuff like that going forward, right? Because why would you do it any other way? So that was one such use case, for example. But say for me, you know, as a content creator making videos, there are principles and aspects that I talk about that require flowcharts and designs that, you know, I would like to bring as graphics on my videos, right? So definitely another plug and play in that sense for me, right? And really quickly, just kind of want to show you for a video that I intend to put a little down the line on the double diamond design process, more on why in that video itself, of course. But, you know, if I just want to really quickly take some content from my script and see if I put it on Napkin AI, am I going to get visuals that I can then bring into the video, tie that into the script a little bit, you know, as I go through what exactly I want to be talking about, right? So selecting that Spark AI and there we go. Okay, not really double diamond in its truest sense, because ideally the double diamond would have been two diamonds, but having layers like this potentially could help me, you know, in terms of thinking of the animation, for example, maybe the cover, the title, something could come in that form, right? Looking at what the four key phases also could be, for example, something to that effect, possibly if if you're trying to show evolution in some sense. Images I will use in the video or not, only one way of finding out, to check it out when it's out. But definitely a use case that makes a lot of sense, right? In terms of how you can easily plug and play the creation of such visuals into another format without any dependencies on anybody. By the way, that may have been a little bit of foreboding of what exactly I want to be talking about right now, which is, of course, my YouTube channel. If at all you like the content thus far, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Check out some of the stuff I talk about, which is a lot of this, right? Helping people get through their creative hustle with tools such as this, become a better freelancer or a solopreneur, for example, tips that you can adopt in your career to kind of climb the ladder, and processes I've used over the years just to kind of achieve the few things that I have. The double diamond design process that I'm going to be making a video on very soon, for example, being one of them. Right, and now imagine if you're going to be using a tool such as this in tandem with something else, say like Google Notebook LM. I've done an extensive deep dive in this video on how exactly you can use Google Notebook LM to do a bunch of crazy things. But with respect to creating a deck, for example, right, really quickly, if you feed your content and your various sources into Notebook LM and really quickly get a few bullet points out from there that you think are perfect to put on the deck, something that I've already done, for example, for a pitch deck that I was working on, right? And then really quickly, for each of those slides that are going to come on screen, taking those pointers, which I very cleanly gotten from Notebook LM with the sources that I'd already given it, and identifying what is the best way to depict all that content in a visual form, right? And I can't tell you the number of decks I've had to make in the 10, 11 years I've been doing all the things that I've done. Pitch decks and strategy decks and whatnot. And as good as I may have gotten doing it for so long, of course, if there's a way that I can make it happen much faster, something that would probably take me a day now, taking me a couple hours to do, I'd be a fool not to incorporate something like this in my setup, right? So something like the big challenge, which of course is something that you want to give a lot more emphasis on in this deck. So maybe just this piece taken as a separate visual, basically, right? So yeah, I don't really want to get into this deck itself and talk about the content that is there over here. Of course, I made a ton of videos on how you can build your portfolio, make pitch decks and stuff like that. But this isn't really a video like that. This is more to kind of show you the use cases of Napkin AI, right? And really quickly through this, I just kind of want to show you all the various layouts that are available and the kind of things that you can actually do with this tool in designing PPTs and newsletters and blogs and what have you. So there you have it. I really hope you start using Napkin AI, checking it out, and more importantly, you enjoyed this video and quick run through of the same. If you did, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Peace out. I'll see you in the next one.